Hello and welcome. How are you doing today? Today I am planning to show you that how I disassemble this Toyota VVTi engines, this cylinder head cover. And now I am talking in that area, what is in here. There is this oil adding cap and hat in here, and there we can see those spark plugs inside of those holes. And now we are planning to take this cylinder head cover, this metallic cover out, and for that you need tool. What size is this? It's this 10 millimeter, and this socket, which in this kind of holes in here, like in here, and there are those bolts in here. If I calculate in here, here is first one, second, third, and here is fourth, and then there is fifth, sixth, seventh, and there is eighth in here. Okay, and we start our disassembling in that bolt in here, and I insert that tool in there, and then I rotate a little bit, and these bolts, they are not very thick, and this is quite soon open. Okay, and here was this first one, what was in here, and then there is second, and this is the second, and there is this third in here. Okay, and all of these are similar. And then there is next in here. And this is the easy part, this bolt taking. And next part, when we take this cover out, it is a little bit complex, and there is this fifth, it is in here, okay, and there was also same size, and next one is in here, and then we have this final, or actually now all, and then there are those two bolts in here, this one and that one, and we take also those away, and these bolts are different, they are longer. And there is also interesting thing that these bolts don't go out. They are like loosened in here. then this next one. And when you can notice that this is loosened, you can notice when this goes up and down in this way. Up and down, okay. And these are in here, and now we have take all of these bolts away. And next part is more complex, because normally this cylinder head cover is quite thick then, and there is glue in this corner areas, and we need now knife and hammer, and we continue. Okay, and next we are opening this aluminium, this cylinder head cover, and for that we need knife. So it is good that it is used an old one, and it can be, this don't have to be sharp. It is only that there is this this light, and this one plate is smaller. And then we install this knife in these holes. Here is one hole when you go in down, and there is first, and when you look this bolt and half inch this lower, there is nice part, and we insert that knife in here. And then we need also that kind of hammer, and then I little bit hammer that, and then this cover normally opens, and now we heard this different kum 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 sound. Okay, and now this opens, and then we carefully do this step carefully that you don't destroy those seals what are in here. And then you go in this all areas in this side and also in that side. You little bit move, and especially in these parts where is this hole. And do not push that knife in very deep in here, only like half inches in here, like so, and you can use your hand in this way. And this way, and also in that area. In here, same thing. Okay, and now, and also in here, okay. And now I think that this cover is released, and I take my hands in here, and I lift up this cover. Actually, I take it here and contact that. And now this cover is in here. Very nice. There is no any things. Okay, and then please insert this cover box in clean place, like table, that we don't insert in here any dirty things inside. Because now in this area there is this, our oil is rolling and running all time, and that's reason why we have to be really carefully that in this area we don't drop any sand or things in there. Okay, and then we can look a little bit closer at this valves, and actually here are those camshafts, and we look in their inside. Okay, and now we are looking in this inside area. Okay, and next we are looking this motor, and these are those two camshafts. Here is first one and there second one, and this was this intake camshaft, because in that area this fuel goes to those cylinder cylinder areas and the pistons, and in that area in here, this is exhaust camshaft, and we have possibility to rotate these camshafts so that when you look in here, there is that kind of small hole, this actually this corners in here, and we can insert our tool in there. And also in these holes we can see that there are those spark plugs inside. Okay, and next we rotate a little bit these camshafts, that's how they works, and then we look a little bit this gasket, what is in here, and we continue. Okay, and next we need tool, what size is this 24 millimeter, and this size fits in these areas, and then when I move that, this camshaft moves, and here is this chain, and now when I rotate this we can see that how this motor works, and this looks, and it seems that I need to take those spark plugs out because there is now so much compression, and next we take those spark plugs out, and before of that I like to show that here is this gasket what is in here, and we can reuse this gasket. I take this little bit out, and when we install in this both areas this gasket glue, and especially in that area and that area where we can see those brown things in here, we have to insert that glue more because there is joint, this metallic joint in here, and here we can see this brown, this is like factory installed glue, but this is possibility to reuse this gasket and seal in here, but if you like to purchase new one, it's also fine. And there is, by the way, gasket in here also, and we need to install in also these areas this glue, and this area is very oily, and then we can look that in here is one sensor, what sensors this camshaft speed, there is one sensor, and this is there is this sensor point what control this camshaft array. Okay, and next I take those spark plugs away. Okay, and next we need that kind of tool system, where is this bar, and that kind of longer support bar what fits in here, and then of course this spark plugs tool, what size is now 16 millimeter, and this is a special measure in these spark plugs, and then I insert that tool in here, and then I only rotate a little bit, and the spark plugs opens, and now I like to take this spark plugs away that we can rotate these pistons. Okay, and here was this first spark plug, and when we do this fast check, this spark plugs looks very good, and then we check also what is this spark plugs brand, and there is this brand is Denso, what is Toyota's original brand, and this is like original this factory line spark plug, I believe. Or then there is possibility to purchase also these spark plugs, and these are very good spark plugs. Also this Japanese NGK is good. Okay, and then next spark plug, and I rotate that. there's this one plug. Now it's inside in there, and then I need to install this last one. And we continue. Okay, and then I take that spark plug away in here. And this tool is nice that, okay, and there is that. And then there was one left in there. Okay, and now all of this spark looks similar. No any issues. Okay, and now when there are no those spark plugs, this rotation using this tool, it's much easier. When I insert the tool in here, now I believe that this motor, okay, now it seems this is much more easier. When I insert in there and now this motor moves and one side per one and it moves, and then we look a little bit closer to this chain area. Okay, here is this chain area, and this is this VTT system what we also disassemble later, and this is this drive chain, and it is metallic. And now when I rotate a little bit this camshaft, we can see that how this motor moves. And it moves in that way. And this motor is now in very well in balance when we have this chain in here. Okay, and this was the information how to disassemble this cylinder head and camshaft cover. And next we continue. And thank you for watching.